Hello guys, welcome back to our Julia tutorial. Today is our third part and we will discuss data types. We will not discuss all data types available in Julia, but just the basic ones, and that should be definitely enough for the beginning. So we will discuss today the integer, float, negative numbers, string, number or string. It's a bit of a problem in programming, or not really problem, but we have to understand it. And comma separated number, that's a special thing in Julia, what we can do to make it easier. So first we start with integers. And integers are all normal numbers, natural numbers like 2 for example. Without any comma, without any point numbers. And that we can just do like here print line 2. This will show us the number 2 just. Julia data types.jl, just here the number 2. And if we want to know the type of this, that I really can prove that I'm not just lying to you, it's really what I say. So we just put in here type of. This is another function which will us show the type of this 2. We have to close it here. We have to close all the parentheses. If we do it now, it shows us here int64. This int stands for integer, and 64 is the number of bits. And the more bits you have, the higher the numbers are, but usually in modern languages it's not a problem, so you can save all numbers. Then let's go to the float numbers. We have also numbers with point. This, for example, is like what we got in the last calculation, 2.0. This is a float number, but it can also be 2.09569564. And this we can also just check here, print line type of 2.0. Then we run the program again and we see here float, also 64 bits. What happens now if you want to do negative numbers? Negative numbers we can also just easily do. We just put before the number a minus sign. And let's do this here, print line. We will check the type of, and here minus 2. And then also a float number, line type of 2.0. And here we can see it's an integer and float, so no special data type. They are just the data types as before. So we can use negative numbers as usual and don't have to think about them. Then let's come to strings. Strings, everything is a string what is inside these quotation marks. And in Julia, these are double quotations. So print line type of, and then we put a string in, like our hello world example in the beginning. And this should show us here that it is a string. So now something that sometimes gives a lot of errors, and if you don't know it, it's a bit difficult to figure out. So that's why I want to show it now at this position or in this tutorial. What happens if we print a number here? If we print it now, it looks like 2. Exactly the same if we write it like print line 2. 2 times exactly the same result. But there's a difference. And the difference is the data type. Type of. If we now run it again, then we see once is a string and once is an integer. And if you want to do now a calculation, for example, with this here, this two, then it will not work because calculation is limited to numbers. Except some specific operation that this I will handle or this I will cover in the next tutorial. But usually it's just for numbers. Then last but not least, we have often comma separated numbers. For example, in math, we like to write 1 billion like this, just to understand it easier. So we can see it on one glance, that is 1 billion. But if we look here, it's a bit difficult to see it. So what happens if we do this in Julia? What we get here is 100. That's definitely not what we wanted. Actually, it's here showing a bit confusing because it looks like 100. That's why you may be confused how this can happen. But if we make here type of, then you can see we got here an error message. So it's not a string and it's also not a number. So what is this really? For this to find out, we put another one. We put here 1100. If we run this, okay, here it's because it connects it, but in real, it's 1 and then 100. So here actually it's a space in between, so these are two numbers. But now if you want to write it like this, we can do it here with the with this underscore. Instead of the commas, and if we print this, then you really get your 1 billion or your 1000 if you like this. Then it's just easier for you to read, but the computer ignores it. And that's what you have to know for data types. The new command we learned in this lecture is type of to identify which type we have. And next time I will talk about the special operation with strings, and see you until then. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss the next video. Until then, see you guys. Bye.